As you probably could tell, it's just Pastor Cody tonight. We don't have Pastor Rob. It's a little bit weird. It's all Cody, all me, all by myself. It's so weird to do this without Robert. For the past few months, it's just been me, Rob. And we've been playing off each other, and we've been doing messages together, and we've just been flowing together in the Holy Spirit. And it's been amazing, right? Yeah? I've really enjoyed hanging out with Rob. I've really enjoyed, you know, building messages together, seeking the Lord together, and really bringing it to Ablaze Youth. And what's really interesting is tonight, even though it's all on me, that really ties into what we are talking about tonight. How sometimes we feel like it's all on us. You know, when I was preparing tonight and I was told that, hey, Cody, you got to do this by yourself, I was like, oh my gosh, it's all on me. And so I immediately felt the weight. I immediately felt the burden. I immediately felt the frustration of, oh man, this is on you, dude. If you mess up, it's all you. Everything is on me. And so there was like this frustration. There was this nervousness. There was this, you know, and we've all felt that. Am I right? How many times in your life have you been like, oh my gosh, all the responsibilities on me, or everything that's happening in my life, I'm feeling like I'm on my own. Every circumstance I come against, I feel like I'm by myself. I can't find my friends. I can't find my family, or whatever the case may be. We feel like we're on this path by ourselves. And what's really interesting when I was thinking about that tonight, how, you know, we're never alone. And what I really want you guys to get tonight, and that's the ultimate, I'm gonna give you the point of the message right now. So if you tune out, I hope you remember this right now. You are never alone. You're never alone. Jesus, God, the Holy Spirit will never leave you. They will never forsake you. You are not in this by yourself. You can be if you want to be, but I believe this and I know this by the Holy Spirit that you are never alone if you ask Him to be a part of your life. If you accept Him as your Lord and Savior and you say, I'm going to walk with you, I'm going to talk with you, I'm going to fellowship with you, I'm going to invite you to be a part of my life, you will never be alone. If you accept Him as that, then you don't have to do it by yourself. You know, I was thinking about last week's message and how fitting some of the scriptures and some of the stories from the Bible really fit to what we're talking about tonight. And if you didn't get a chance to listen to last week's message, then I implore you to go back and check it out, because even, you know, some of the things I'm gonna be talking about, Pastor Rob had a lot to add into it, so it really just brings a lot more light to everything. But to kind of sum up and recap a little bit, you know, we talked about how the disciples, you know, they were out there on the water doing the plan of God. They were out there on the water crossing the sea, and that was when the crazy storm came up and all the water was coming in. It was rushing over them, and it was scary, and it was dark, and it was like chaotic, and there was all this weight and all this pressure and all this coming against them, and they didn't know what to do. They were scared, they were lonely, they might have even felt depressed, or maybe they felt lonely. They weren't lonely, you know, they had each other, but they felt lonely. They felt like all the pressure was on them. You know, they didn't want to wake up God. They didn't want to wake up Jesus in the back of the boat, because they didn't want to disturb Him. They didn't want to make Him, like, you know, come out of His rest to deal with their situation, because they felt like, hey, this is on us. This is us. We were told to go across the sea, so we got to do something about it. So in their own strength, you know, I'm sure they were trying to bail water out of the boat or whatever, and they're trying to figure out how to not die on their own. But at some point, they had to realize, oh no, I cannot do this on my own. Because if I do, I'm going to die. If I try to do this on my own, maybe I won't die, but I'm going to make a mess of it. Either the boat was for sure gonna sink and they were gonna drown, or their boat was gonna get severely damaged and they were gonna have a hard time in the next time that they traveled, or whatever the case may be, the situation that they were up against, the circumstances that were around them, if they tried to do it in their own strength, surely death would come upon them. But then they realized, I need to go to Jesus. I need to go to the Creator. We talked about this last week, that Jesus is on your boat. Your boat is you. The Holy Spirit is within you, and all you have to do is say, yo, Jesus, help me out. And what did He do? He woke up from his sleep and he was like, all right, I'm gonna bring peace to this storm. And he spoke to their situation. He spoke to their circumstance, and he brought calm to their situation, and it allowed them to get safely to the other side. And what's so amazing is that they were on a destination. God told them to go across that sea. Jesus was like, hey, we need to go on the other side. And if they had basically bowed to their fears, or overcome to their frustration, overcome to their fear, they would have never made it to the other side. If they never realized, I just need to go to God with this, if they never realized, hey, you know, I'm not alone in this, if they never realized that, then they would have never made it to the other side. They never would have healed the demon-possessed man. They would have never set that man free. They had a reason that they were going to the other side. They didn't know it in that moment, but when they got there, they're like, oh, That's why Jesus called us over here. See, a lot of times we're going through our life, we're going and doing the things that God has called us to do, and we feel frustration sometimes, we feel like we're alone, we feel this burden like God has called us to do this and it's all on me, and if I screw this up, I'm gonna taint God. If I screw this up, people are gonna think Christians are sucky, or whatever the case may be, but that is not true. You're not on your own. You know, we talked about over in John 14, and John 14 in its entirety is absolutely amazing. You need to go back and like really dig deep into that scripture because it's about 30 verses and we do not have the time to read through every single verse. But you know, he talks about how he's the way, the truth, and the life. And then ultimately, Jesus had to go so that way the comforter, the advocate could come to us, to live inside of us. You know, he's meant to comfort us in times of trial, comfort us in times of turmoil. He's meant to bring peace to us, like it says over in verse 27. The peace that God gives, the peace that Jesus gives, the peace that the comforter gives is like no peace that man can give. It's an everlasting peace. Jesus is the creator of peace. So why not go to the one that created peace when we're feeling like we're alone? And we're feeling like it's all on us. You know, it's so interesting to me when people talk about how, you know, when we're doing things for God, sometimes it feels like a little like uneasy and we're like, oh, I don't know if I want to do this. And it feels a little bit like, it feels weird in my spirit. And but as soon as you follow after what God has called you to do, immediately peace comes. You know, maybe it's a little bit scary to our flesh, or maybe it's a little bit uncomfortable to our flesh, but as soon as we obey what God has called us to do, there's immediately peace. I've never felt bad about helping someone see Jesus. I've never felt guilt about giving someone a blessing. I've never felt turmoil about helping someone I've never felt turmoil about helping someone grow closer to God. I've immediately felt peace because it's what God had called me to do, and it's what Jesus had wanted me to do. But if I had never sought after the peacemaker, if I had never sought after the one that called me to do it, I would have never felt comfort. I would have never felt ease when I was going for it. So what I want you guys to really think about over these next couple weeks, over this next time that maybe you're alone in your home or whatever, you are not actually alone. You might feel shut off from society. You might feel cut off from this world right now, but I want you to know this, that you are not alone. Jesus is for you, Jesus is with you, and he will never leave you, never forsake you. What did we talk about in the book of James? It says that if you need wisdom, you just ask. If you need help, you just ask. If you need a word from God, you just ask. You know, and it says over here in John 14, 26, and we were talking about John 14. This is out of the Passion Translation. I recommend reading all of it in the New Living Translation because the New Living is so awesome, but I love how it says this in the Passion. When the Father sends the Spirit of Holiness, the one like me who sets you free, he will teach you all things in my name. He will inspire you to remember every word that I've told you. You know, you might say, I don't understand what the Holy Spirit sounds like. I don't understand, you know, when Jesus is talking to me. I implore you to do this. I want you to go and read your Bible. I know that seems like such like a basic Christian thing to say, like, oh, I'm having trouble. I don't know what to do. Read your Bible. Well, I need you to read your Bible because the more familiar that you get with God's word, the more familiar you'll understand God's language. You know, it talks about in John 1 that Jesus is the Word, always was the Word, always will be the Word. I might have screwed that up a little bit, but essentially, Jesus is the Word. And so if you understand the Word, if you read the Word, if you get to know the Word, you're ultimately getting to know the language of God. You get to understand how Jesus talks. You get to understand how the Holy Spirit ministers to you. If you're familiar with the Word, if you're familiar with that voice, when you're led, when you're guided, when you're going, navigating through situations, you'll be better understanding of the Word when he calls you to do something. I challenge you guys this week. Be receptive to the word that the Holy Spirit is talking to you about. And understand this, that you are not alone. You are not alone. I want you to be sensitive to that voice that lives on the inside of you. I want you to be sensitive to his spirit when he talks to you. If you feel like you're supposed to go do something, I want you to obey it. If you feel like you're not supposed to do something, I want you to obey it. This is preparation for what God has called you to do. Start listening to that voice now. Start listening and responding to that voice now. So when he calls you to bigger and greater things, it's so much easier to obey the word of God. It's so much easier to obey the commands of the Spirit. So that when you're out there on the water, just like the disciples were, and something crazy is going on, you're not waiting to see, are we gonna die? You're not waiting to be like, okay, now it's getting bad. Oh my gosh, now we're about to sink. No, no, no. As soon as the sign of trouble starts, you're just like, you know what? I'm gonna go to God about this because I know I am not as smart as he is. I know his word is better than my word. And so you're going to go to the source of peace immediately. God is so good. God is so amazing. And I want you to realize that the greater one, the good one, the amazing one lives on the inside of you. Grab a hold of that truth and walk it out every single day. We love you guys so much. We are praying for you every single day. And we think that you are amazing. And we believe that you are called to impact this world in such an amazing and mighty way. We love you guys so much. Don't think you're alone. We are for you. Jesus is for you. And we're always gonna be for you. Seek after God, listen to his word, and obey the voice of the Holy Spirit every single day. Father God, I just thank you for every single student of Ablaze Youth Ministries that's watching right now, or maybe even those that aren't in youth that are seeing this message. God, I just thank you that you are speaking to them right now, that you are guiding them in this situation, or you're guiding them in their walk with you, Lord. I just thank you that you're ministering to them, that you're speaking to them, that you're equipping them, that you're drawing them out of things and getting them closer to you tonight, God. I just thank you that whatever the case may be, no matter what it feels like, no matter what it looks like, that they realize tonight that they are never alone and that you are always with them, that you live on the inside of them, and that you have a place that is always going to be available for them, that they have access to you anytime, anywhere, any place, at all times, in all needs, in all situations. All they have to do is just knock on your door and that you will open it up to them and say, hey, what do you need? Do you need wisdom? Do you need guidance? Do you need help? Do you need something from me? Do I need to help you navigate this situation? That you are always going to be there to get them through everything. God, I pray for that one person right now that just seems to have so much doubt in their life about who you are, that you help them realize that you are the way, the truth, and the life that John 14 speaks about. God, I just pray right now that they are receptive to that truth and that they grab a hold of it for the rest of their days. We thank you for your word. We thank you for the Spirit that lives on the inside of us. We just thank you for all that you are. We thank you that you help us every single day to get where you've called us to go. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.